Crawford lays it up, and then almost got very ugly, and the referees just stood by and watched it. But right now it's Calvin Bruton. There's been a switch, and there goes Crawford shooting over the top of Pierce.
Scott Fenton with the ball is on for his first run tonight, and I must admit, the Wildcats look better in my mind when Cal Bruton uses the point guard. Now they've brought Scott Fenton on in replace Eric Watterson. He's a little bit taller, but Watterson's trouble is his speed. Al Green was able to get away with him, so Scott Fenton really in the hot seat.
Bruton just outside the three-point line. He's going to drive towards the basket. That's a strong drive from the smallest man on the court.
Turnover, Tony Pinder. It's a four-on-two break. Bruton holds up, gets the two.
This is Keogh. Pinder knocking it away from Torrance, but it comes back to Torrance. Now Crawford with Keogh to beat. Bruton from outside the three-point line. Keogh with the rebound. Still a five-point game. Keogh goes looking for Morrissey. Brilliantly intercepted by Torrance. The Wildcats are working hard at the moment. There's a great interception by Carfino. He'll probably try and do it all himself. Waits for support. Brad Dalton back to Carfino. Gee, he showed lightning fast reflexes and hands and finishes off with the points. The record between these two teams, 7-5, as Torrance goes all the way.
Low post Morrissey, tries to go baseline. Still he goes, slapped away by Pinder. Great defense. 2-on-1 break. Crawford felt. Got it to Bruton. And Bruton drives in. Carfino crashes in under the basket. Ellis cross court. That's an ambitious pass. Look out, Calvin. Whoa. Whoa.
Well, needless to say, Brad Dalton involved in that, and Bruton's gone down.
The Dalton boys, eh?
Off the bench, out of the east.
In the Battle of the Cats, Crawford opened the scoring.
First basket of the game to James Crawford.
And Cal followed up with this super pass.
Great no-look pass to Trevor Torrance, who goes up and makes the ball.
And then a three-point bomb.
Bruton makes three.
Rookie Hill showed he had the moves as well.
Hill puts it up and makes good.
Rowe was showing the form that's made him one of the season's star recruits.
The 10-second warning shot goes, but Rowe makes the lane and the basket. 12 plays 8.
Mike Ellis was in hot form early.
This is Ellis.
Robbie Dempster, number 24, in for the Wildcats for the first time. Crawford, Perth was ready to go down to the other end and score quickly. Crawford can't find it. Gets his shot, dishes to Pinder. Good second effort by James Crawford.
So two team fouls each in this very physical third period. Crawford working on Holmgren. Shot off the glass, it's there.
Perth, through the efforts of Crawford, is making him look good, but that was a great pass inside to Aubrey Sherrod.
Sharon Rowe picks up the assist. Sherrod now with 14 points.
Geelong persisting in the zone, a 2-3 zone, guarding a space on the floor rather than a specific man. Crawford over the top, Pinder can't gather the ball cleanly, so the shot wasn't accurate like he would have hoped.
The captain of the team since 1982, point guard for them, Crawford moving baseline. Oh. Slam! Now that is decisive. Here's the shot, no, intercepted. The pass, not the shot, down to Gaze, and so Melbourne turn it over. Perth again, Kuiper, slam! Last three trips down for Perth, have come up with nothing.
Torrance again finding that avenue to the basket. Pinder with another big offensive rebound and drawing the foul.
14 fouls, Dennis, for the Spectres.
Pinder to Torrance, banks it in off the glass.
The Wildcats with a three-point break over the Spectres. Ellis with good speed to get in front of his opponent. That was Lucas. Crawford with the rebound. Tower got his hand to it. Torrance kept it in play. And Ellis put it in the basket. This is Lucas. He goes inside to Utoff, who's got Pinder with him. Pinder's doing a sterling job at the moment. And the Wildcats' defense is brilliant.
Great work by Pinder.
who makes himself available at the other end of the court. Jumper from the top of the key is good from Crawford. Kiefer played just over 13 minutes last week in the victory over Eastside Melbourne. No doubt we'll see more court time tonight. Oh, how's that for a start?
He's a solid fellow, 106 kilos. Very different physique to their other 18-year-old. Turner, as Fenton puts the shot up. Well, at least they're lighting up the scoreboard again. He's got a job and a half. This is Johnson. They've got less than 10 seconds. Oh, that was Jones.
Scored 25 in that victory. Fenton gets the three. Working with Ellis, who drives the baseline. Nice move, didn't go. Crawford gets the slam.
He's the former Boomer centre, is Ray Borner. There's the steal affected by James Crawford. Hang on to your seats. The Wildcats want one shot only. And Bruton has indicated that he's going to take it. He tries to go through Graham, out to Ellis. 3 seconds to play. What a spectacular shot by Mike Ellis. And there's the buzzer. Tigers have turned it over. Ellis with the steal, drives to the basket and it drops. The Wildcats are out of the blocks very quickly. This is Gordon, who takes the Wildcats defence on. The pass was wayward. Ellis takes Andrew Gaze on and goes to the basket. And Davis with the rebound. Mike Ellis in his 200. Gives it to Bruton. Bruton gets around Gribble. The look away pass to Torrance. And the Wildcats are out of the blocks very quickly again.
Pinder. That was ambitious. Torrance has got it though. Over Gribble for two.
Pinder for two. Nice shot from Tiny. The Wildcats quickly inbound the ball. Pinder pulls up for two again. Nice shooting. Well, there's no doubt about it. Tiny's right on target early in this game.
Hill inside to Everett. The fall away jumper comes up short. Pinder tries to get the rebound. He can't. Comes off Mike Ellis's chin. They run it out quickly. The Wildcats all the way. The captain makes a great basket. Turner.
Both teams not shooting well.
Johnson, three-point attempt. Can't make it. Lips out. Rebound by Perth. Bruton with the ball now. What can he do? Gets it out to Ellis in a fashion. Ellis gets around. Michael Johnson gets it inside to Davis. That's a great basket.
Screen was set there by Bolden. Joyce gets the shot off. It was well short. Ellis, again, a lot of courage. Just going at that ball. Dishes it off. Torrance goes in. Big slam from Trevor Torrance. And it's out to 14. The Wildcats need a basket. This trip down the floor. Davis out to Watterson. This is Torrance. Back to Watterson. Davis goes baseline. Oh, great move. Armisen in front of Torrance. Ellis. There's baseline again. Bounce pass finds Pinder. Bruton with the three-point shot. It goes. 72 to 60. If we look at the turnovers, there's nothing between either side with 15 apiece. Eric Watterson goes for the basket, puts it in. Part owner Kerry Stokes nods approvingly. Dishes it off nicely, but Morrissey couldn't find it. It goes again baseline. Harmison tried to tip it in. Pinder the rebound. Harmison in close attendance. Pinder dishes it out. Watterson finds Crawford. It goes baseline and it drops.
It's going to go to Taylor or to Hubbard whenever Illawarra get the ball.
Tiny Pinder.
We're inside the last minute as Cal Bruton launches from two-point range and makes it 123 to 115 and counting down.
Well, they're queuing up, as you can see. Torrance has got it. He inbounds to Pinder. We're down to 7 seconds now. Bruton in the backcourt needs to bring it up. You can hear the countdown in the background. Look at Bruton go, and that finishes his night. Well, almost. But he'll be happy enough. The Wildcats, despite the problems they've had in recent times, have finished third in the NBL after the qualifying round. They'll have home court advantage against the Adelaide 36ers.
But again, the Wildcats outscored in that final quarter, John Gardner, 29-27. Yes, there was a worry there as they certainly didn't play any structured offense. But that is the highest position that Wildcats have attained in the regular season in their history in the NBL, to finish third. And that's a very commendable effort when you take into account the trials and tribulations of the past 4 or 5 weeks. Well, yes. The Wildcats trailed by 2 at quarter time, led by 16 at half time, by 8 at 3 quarter time, and by 4 at the end of the game.
Alan Black in his rookie season
amongst his players there, the last qualifying game on this court, a memorable one, their highest finish, as John told you. They finished third behind the Canberra Cannons in North Melbourne. Put your best foot forward, do what you think.